Hello, everybody, and welcome to my review of Rurouni Kenshin, The Beginning. This review is going to be a lot shorter and simpler than my review of the prior movie, The Final. The reason being is that much of what I said there applies here. The action scenes, hey, they're still amazing. In this film, though, they're a lot more gritty and more bloody. That isn't surprising as the subject matter and what it has to depict. The storytelling, hey, it's still at the same bar as the rest of the series. Regarding the beginning, though, some scenes play out differently from the anime OVA that you may remember or the manga, but they still do tell the same story. They just take a different route to get there. Basically, this film maintains the same high bar quality that the series has been known for. It's an absolute 10 out of 10. Now that said, I'm going to get into a few points that really stuck out to me. So, one of the first things I want to mention is that I'm very happy to report that there's a little bit more humor from the manga here than in prior entries. This is still a very sad and tragic story, but for some reason, this movie does have more jokes than you may have seen from the prior films. Specifically, jokes about Tomoe's similarities to Kenshin, as well as a few, hey, way to go, player nods when Kenshin brings Tomoe into the residence that he is hiding out at. And I also want to mention that there is a surprise and frankly an odd choice for a cameo. I really don't feel like it's any spoiler worth noting, as it's just basically a bit of a walk-on, but Sakurai, the swordsman that forges Kenshin's Sakabato, or reverse blade sword, in the series and the manga, he actually shows up for a cameo. The reason I say this is a surprise and a little bit odd is that we've never actually seen this character. There's only one time that he actually shows up in the anime and manga, and in both instances, he's in silhouette. We never see his face, but we do here. It's an interesting little cameo. Manga and anime fans will probably really enjoy it. But like I said, it's a bit of an odd choice. I'm surprised they didn't go for maybe Aoshi doing a walk-on, or maybe the Neone Wabenshu showing up, as we never actually saw the group in the live-action films. But hey, it's a nitpick. I'm letting it go. Moving away from the honorable mentions there for a moment is, if I were really going to describe this film to a Kenshin newbie or to someone scrolling through Netflix and seeing this film, I'd honestly have to say it's a samurai period piece with a very dark and emotional tone to it. It's about a character who starts out with nothing but noble intentions, but eventually becomes warped and driven a type of insane. And later in the film, events occur that brings him back from the edge, but at the same time, they scar him in ways that are going to define him. It's a very tragic film. It's not a feel-good film. And as I said, the film is going to end on a very somber and dark note. But it also does set up the character to find redemption and peace of mind later on in the series. So if you're a fan of those kind of films that really go to hit you in the feels, and this film definitely does that, you would definitely enjoy that. And like I said, since it's really the beginning of this character's story and journey, it's also worth noting that, you know, the story doesn't end there. He eventually does find the peace of mind that you want him to find. And you know what? I am going to start to wrap up now, because there really isn't much more I can say other than to rave over and over again how good this film is, in the sense that it tells the story it needs to tell so effectively. It adapts the story so loyally and lovingly from the manga. Everything in it is, again, gold star standard in adapting a comic book. A standard so high that regardless of what you think of the MCU or the DCEU, this is my gold star standard. This is a standard that's above those noted universes. the Kenshin film series is a film series that has hit that gold star again and again, and I would recommend it to anyone who was looking for an excellent comic book film. And just to really conclude, and if I could just wax a little nerd philosophical for a moment, it's an interesting parallel that the story that most Western... So to wrap up and really conclude, I'm just very relieved that one of my favorite anime characters and one of my favorite manga stories has gotten such an amazing and respectful treatment on the big screen. The Rurouni Kenshin live-action series of films is amazing. It had an amazing start way back in 2012. And now in 2021, it's had an amazing conclusion. And it's been first-rate all the way through. So, and the way the film ends is absolutely brilliant. It's the final shot is very similar to what George Lucas did when he ended the prequel trilogy. And so... such an amazing way to end this film series. And frankly, I don't think the ending shot could have been done any better. So thank you for tuning in. I know this review is much shorter, but really, there's only so many ways that I can rave and rant and say, hey, this film is amazing. I feel like I've really just touched on all the really great points of that Kenshin fans would need to see, as well as maybe summing up the film for newer fans. Thank you for tuning in. I'll be back soon with some more video game reviews. Thanks for tuning. Hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button. Support the channel. And I'll be back soon. Thank you.